Snakes are a striking example of evolutionary innovation, descendants of ancient reptiles that once walked on four limbs. Over millions of years, they have reshaped their anatomy, physiology, and behavior, adapting to a wide range of ecological niches. Now, through the power of genetics, scientists are uncovering the molecular mechanisms behind their extraordinary transformation. I'm Dr. Krutik Patel, PhD, and in today's Scientific Journal Club, we'll explore the groundbreaking research that reveals the genes behind these legless apex predators. In a monumental study published in Cell by Peng et al., researchers conducted an extensive genomic analysis on snakes. This study leveraged a dataset of 28 snake genomes, combining 14 newly assembled genomes and 14 previously sequenced ones, alongside the genomes of 6 lizards and 1 turtle to enable comparative analysis. Several genomic features were identified. Snake-specific structural variants, SSSVs, were large genomic insertions or deletions, at least 50 base pairs long, that were unique to snakes and absent in outgroups, such as lizards. And these are likely genes that evolved from the last common ancestor of all the snakes in this study. Orthologous genes were genes that were shared between snakes and lizards, reflecting ancestral genes that have been conserved across evolution and are not unique to snakes. These researchers also found newly evolved snake genes. These were genes that were largely found in the snake species and rarely seen in the lizard species, suggesting evolutionary innovation specific to snake lineages. The opposite was also found. Lost genes, often found in the lizard species and not found in the snake species, were considered genes that snakes lost throughout their evolutionary journey. They also found snake-derived conserved non-coding elements, SDCNEs, highly conserved non-coding regulatory regions near genes that originated in the snake lineages, pointing to important regions of the genome which may control the expression of different genes. Finally, RNA was also extracted and examined in multiple tissues of different snakes and other species for other types of comparative studies. All in all, they had a lot of data and a lot of snakes, and they found some very funky genes. Let's get into it. One of the most striking features of snakes is, of course, their lack of limbs. They slither around. This study uncovered several interesting genes that may have contributed to this trait. RD10, a gene crucial for limb development, was completely lost in snakes. CPLANE1 had snake-specific deletions. In humans, mutations in CPLANE1 can lead to oral facial digital syndromes. This causes craniofacial issues, limb malformations, and uneven joint digits. The sonic hedgehog pathway is known to be essential for limb formation, and one of the genes that encodes a receptor within this pathway has several snake-specific deletions in it. A 17 base pair deletion in the ZRS enhancer region of the PTCH1 gene, known to regulate limb formation, was deleted in all snake genomes. However, this deletion also appears in some lizard species, suggesting it's not the sole factor of limb loss. To test the functional impact of this deletion, researchers used CRISPR-Cas9 to replicate the ZRS enhancer deletion in mice. The mutated mice displayed shorter limbs and altered digit development, confirming the gene's role in limb formation. However, this also confirms there are further genes to discover in limb loss and limb formation. It's certainly not just a few. Snakes lost more than just their legs, though. They're not all that great at seeing in well-lit light. Many genes associated with photoreception and lens development, such as SLC1A2 and ESRRB, were lost, contained deletions, or had altered regulation in snakes, suggesting the most common recent ancestor of snakes may have been a subterranean dweller, and the lack of not seeing in well-lit light was an evolutionary neutral or positive selection pressure for them. Furthermore, a snake-specific deletion was found in CC2D2A. In humans, mutations in this gene lead to microphthalmia. I think I said that right. In humans, this leads to abnormally small eyes. This indicates mutations found in this gene could be linked to the small eyes we see in snakes. So, we've discussed a lot about what snakes have lost, but we should also mention what they've gained. Snake species such as boas and pythons can use heat vision. Yeah, that is awesome. PMP22 is a gene which plays a key role in cellular response to heat. NFIB is a gene which is associated with sensory neural functions. Snakes which can use infrared sensitivity for vision have SDCNEs associated with these genes. This means these genes are under alternative regulation when compared to non-infrared sensitive snakes. Based on that, it might not be too long until we can mutate our own cyclopses. Overall, this was a truly amazing paper to read. I highly recommend it, as I could not provide all of its information in a single video. If you learned something new or cool about snakes or genetics, please give this video a like and subscribe, and please join me next time for more science.